So, over the course of the next couple of episodes, I'm going to show you some different approaches on how to make your city or like drawing, crafts, diorama, Lego build, Minecraft build, Unreal Engine project look post-apocalyptic in different ways and different stages in time. Right, so in the last video, I was doing the post-apocalypse, which is quite an interesting topic. I like to draw that a lot, but I thought it'd be good if I did a tutorial on it because I kind of went headfirst in. Maybe you might need to do some help catching up. So I have like the basic outline of a city, and so what I'm going to do is show you how to age the buildings. So when you're drawing stuff, you want pretty much all the buildings to be on the same page, otherwise it just looks like a bit of a mess if one thing looks like it's 1,000 years into the future and the other thing looks like it's like a week after it's been bombed, then it doesn't really add up, if that makes sense. So I'm going to show you how to do that. This So after that has just reinforced my personality, and I now understand even more that I hate drawing squares. So most of these buildings, they do look really simple. I did rush them. But basically, this is before post-apocalyptic event. So this is just how it would be normally. Then, as we go up, I'm going to show you how to do them in different time periods. Okay, so now this is it normally, and then this is it 10 years after the post-apocalyptic event. So, as you can see, like the signs, the direction signs on the overpass have started to come down a bit. And then I left these bits blank just because I wanted to show you how to do it. So if we take this building for an example, I wanted to show some kind of signs of decay. So I've taken a little bit off the roof. So you just do a little thing like that. Then for here, I'm going to show the outline of where the windows would have been. So there's a bit of the concrete that's just started to come in, like that basically. So that is 10 years. Then I'm going to show you 100 years. All these squares are really hurting my hands, by the way. It's really annoying. Right, so now this is 100 years into the future. So as you can see, it's really starting to show like the damage. So there's a lot more gaps in the buildings. Like this whole area has just been taken off, or it's fallen off. There's a gap in the overpass which wasn't there 90 years ago, and the buildings are generally more crumbled. Now, going 900 years into the future, so 10 times the state that this is in, it practically looks like an alien planet. I usually don't draw when I'm drawing post-apocalyptic scenery. I usually don't draw like 1,000 years into the future because it kind of just looks like trees and stuff. I usually stick around like 100 years or 10 years after a post-apocalyptic event. So this is what 1,000 years looks like. Boom. 1,000 years APAE just flattened. There's nothing left of the overpass, basically hardly anything left of the buildings. They're like three stories high most. The smaller buildings, like the ones around here, are basically just rubble, like the foundations are left. Because this is just showing you the state of the buildings, there are different ways that you could like disguise the buildings. So like if this is in a snowy region, then everything is going to be covered in snow, or it's going to be like covered in trees if it's in a jungly region. So if this is also 1,000 years into the future and it's like a foresty area, like the trees are going to be this high, so you're basically not going to see any of the rubble, and the rubble's basically just going to look like mud because it's going to be so like covered. So yeah, that's 1,000 years APAE. So if you want to see different ways you can texture your buildings, I'm going to do a demonstration on how to put like trees and leaves onto them. So that's going to be for the next episode. So I hope you enjoyed this short tutorial of all the different stages that the city would go through, and I'll see you in the next episode.